Hello, good morning students. Today we are going to start our next chapter, that is local government. Okay?
The chapter name is local government. First of all, I want to tell you about the government's level. The powers are divided into many levels. Into many levels in India, like first one is the central government, second one is state government. In the central government, parliament makes the rules and regulation for the complete country, and next one is the state government. The state government comes under the central government and makes the rules and regulation for the state only. Okay, and under the state government, third one is the local government. The local government do the work for the welfare of their locality. Okay, clear? Third one is your local government, that is take care of your welfare, take care of their locality. Yeah, you can say. Government, which government at the level of village and district? Local government, which government? That is
at the village and district level closest to the common people. As I told you, the local government take care of their locality. It means the local government is very closer to their villagers. Okay, and you can say there are three tier system in India according to 73rd amendment and 74th amendment. In the 73rd amendment, three tier system in village, yeah, you can say local area, and three tier systems in urban area. Okay, under 73rd amendment, three tier system in the local area or village area, and 74th amendment in three tier system in urban area. Okay, urban area means beta cities. Involves the day to day life and problems of ordinary citizens. The local government solve our problems and involve in our daily life, if any problems, to the villagers. Then the villagers can solve with the help of their local government. The local government having some powers, if any problem is there, if any small problem is there in the village, you can say at the small level, then the local government can solve these types of problems. Okay? Believes that local knowledge and local interests are essential ingredients for democratic decision making, also necessary for efficient and people friendly administration. As we know that in India democracy system is there. Which system is there, beta? Democracy system is there. Yeah, you can see in India democratic government is there. Okay, and what the democratic says? Yeah, what is the basic point of the democracy? Democracy means, beta, every person having the right to choose, or every person having the right to take participation in the politics. Okay, it means every person. What do you understand by the every person? Every person means, beta, every person of the country, there should be no discrimination on the behalf of color, caste and sex. Okay, and now the government of the people giving equal
the government of the people give all the right to the villagers. That's why the villagers also take participation in the politics. Okay, that's why local government is there, and with the local government, the people, the citizen of the villages are very closest. Okay, here are many advantages of the local government. First one is that it is so near to the people. Advantages of local government. Advantages of local government. First one is the local government is very closer. Local government is very closer. You can say closer. If any type of government will be the closer of the villagers, then the villagers will share their experience and will put their necessary in front of the government. Okay, beta. It is the first and the important advantages of the local government. The local government is very closer to the villagers. Next one is convenient for the people to approach the local government. Convenient to the people means, as we know that if any problem is there, it is the normal thing in society, always the dispute arises. Okay, and in the village, if any type of dispute is there, with the help of the local government, the people can easily solve their conflict. Okay, there will be no chance of the crime. Clear? It is convenient to the people. It is very convenient for the people of the villages, because the villagers people are not very aware and not very educated. Okay, that's why if any problem is there, they can solve this type of problem with the help of their local government. Okay, third one is, it is at the level of the local government that common citizens can be involved in decision making. Third one is, beta, every person of the village who has crossed 18 years give the vote to their sarpanch. Okay, it means you can say that every person of the village take participate in the election. Okay, third year, beta, here one question, one important question arises in front of you, that how the local government is made important basic point for the democracy. In the answer of this question, you can write down, because in the local government, every person, yeah, the lowest person of the country, lowest person means beta, not smaller person. Now, on the behalf of this answer, he wants to say to you about that a single person of the country can take the participation in the politics. Okay? Your third advantages of local government, that is the local citizens take participation in the election of the sarpanch. Okay. Next one is growth of the local government in India. That how the local government come in the politics. Okay. Firstly, the Mahatma Gandhi gave the idea of the local government. Growth of the local government. And how the local government comes in here?
Indian politics. Self-governing village communities existed in India from the earliest time in the form of Sabha.
As we know that, and I want to tell you one more thing in the local government. Under the local government, one community is there, one group is there, that is called Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha. It is very important committee or council, or you can say union or group of the village. All the people of village are the members of the Gram Sabha. Okay, it is compulsory for every village. Okay, beta. And 3 meetings are compulsory in within 6 months. Got it, beta? Gram Sabha. In Gram Sabha, all the people of the village who cross the age of 18, all the people comes in here Gram Sabha and gave their decision. Okay, and the Gram Sabha members tells the Gram Panchayat how the Gram Panchayat have to take the decision for the village. Okay, beta. Any problem to anyone? Now clear to everyone, beta, about the Lok Sabha or Gram Sabha. Here I want to tell you about the difference between the Gram Sabha and the Gram Panchayat. Everyone is Gram Panchayat. In the Gram Sabha, all the members of the villages who cross the 18 years are the member of the Gram Sabha, and in Gram Panchayat, who are elected by the, yeah, who are the representative of the persons of the villagers, only these members comes in your Gram Panchayat. Here,
in the course of time, these village bodies took the shape of the panchayat, and these panchayats resolved issues at the village level.
All the people of the Gram Panchayat wants to solve the problem of the people, of the villagers, because these are the representative of our villagers.
Okay, beta, clear? Next one is the Government of India Act 1990. Village panchayat were established in a number of provinces.
Here, before the 1947, also the Gram Panchayat were there. Okay, in the Britishers' time, the oldest people of the village solve the dispute of the village. But after the independence, after getting the independence on the behalf of the Gandhi vision, the Indian government gave the powers to the local government. Okay, clear, beta? Before the 1992, there was no powers within the hand of the Gram Panchayat. Okay, but after the 73rd and 74th amendment in the constitution, the central power, the government of the power, gave some powers to the local government. Okay,
in modern times, elected local government bodies were created after 1882. Lord Ripon, who was the Viceroy of India at the time, took the initiative in creating these bodies. The Lord Ripon play an important role.
Lord Ripon play an important role in the creation of the local bodies.
In the 1882, Lord Ripon gave the permission to make the Gram Panchayat when he was the Viceroy of the India. Okay, Lord Ripon gave some powers to the oldest people of the village who can take the decision on the behalf of government. Okay, the Lord Ripon played an important role in the 1882. Okay, after the 1882, the local government was created. okay. Panchayats were looked upon as instrument of decentralization of participatory democracy.
As we know that in India, federal system is there. Federal system is there, and in the federal system, the power of division comes. And in India, power division are there in horizontally and vertically also. Okay, in India, union government is there, state government is there, and after the state government, local government is there. The local government makes the rules and regulation for the their locality. Okay, beta. In the 73rd amendment, in the 73rd amendment, there is a three-tier system. In the 73 amendment, the Gram Panchayat will do the work for the welfare of their village.
When the constitution was prepared, the subject of the local government was assigned to the states. It was also mentioned in the directive principle as one of the policy directive all the governments in the country.
After the independence, it was in the hand of the state government. Then the state government wants to divide their powers. Okay, after the independence, you can say after the independence, it was depend on the state government. The state government wants to divide their power with the help of local government or not. Okay, but in the starting of the independence year, the state government doesn't give the powers to the local government.
Okay, being a part of the directive principle of state policy, the provision of the constitution was not justifiable and primarily advisory in its nature.
In the starting of the independence year, the local government, yeah, you can say the power of division at the level of local, it was also a directive principle. Here, directive principle, a new word for you. Directive principle. As you read about the fundamental duties and the fundamental rights, directive principle are saying the fundamental rights. Okay, but after the directive principle, there is no jurisdiction's power. Okay, jurisdiction's power means if any person exploit your fundamental right, then the state, then the government of the India will give punishment to you. Okay, but if any person exploit the directive principle, then there is no jurisdiction power behind the directive principle. Okay, beta. Now clear to everyone till now? If any problem to you, then you can comment.
Your next one is beta clear. Your next topic is. The subject of the local government, including panchayats, did not receive adequate importance. As I told you, before the 1992, the state did not give the powers to the Gram Panchayat. Firstly, the turmoil due to the partition resulted in a strong unitary inclination in the constitution.
First of all, as you read about the federal system in the India, in the federal system, power division is there. Power divided into three levels. First one is the central list. Here you can say union list. Second one is state list. third one is all current list. In the center